Ladies and gentlemen, we want you in great voice tonight.
Full thanks to Rectangle Images. We're in the welterweight division, ladies and gentlemen. This is for other amateur rules in the C-class division. So that means there is no punching to the head while the combatants are on the ground. All right, first of all, in our blue corner, he weighed in at 75.1 kilos. He's on debut here tonight. He trains under Paul Birch, and he fights out of tribal MMA on the Sunshine Coast. Please give it up for Drop. His opponent in our red corner, weighing at 76.2 kilos, having his second fight here tonight in the total. He trains under Gregor Soria and fights out of Harvey Bay, BJJ on the Sunshine Coast.
Wow, that was a hell of an explosion. That was great.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at John's body, he was just built for speed and power. And he just showed that move.
Ken Mcandrew offering to keep that attempted sort of guillotine on the fence, which he might find starts to ache his arm a little bit after a while.
Yeah, but Ken's lucky. He's got a height advantage, so he can really add some weight to that crank. So. But he's okay, it's actually keeping him up right now, so he seems okay. Stop that
break. And referee Thomas Churchill goes in to break the guys up, wants a bit more action from these guys.
I really like how relaxed Kim is. And his Southport too, he's going to pose a problem there. But
well, they're both pretty relaxed for debut guys, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, so the C-class rules, when on the ground, there's quite a few different things. There's, you know, with rotational leg locks and stuff like that. Obviously, the striking to the head while they're on the ground. Their up kicks are a little bit different. In C-class, I think they can only up kick to the leg, if I'm not mistaken. B-class, they can go to the body. And in the pros, they can also up kick to the head. So just a few differences. Obviously, the main aim of that's differences in the class divisions or so. We can have guys come in with no experience and try and get a bit of a handle on this whole MMA thing.
There you go, there goes John again with that blitz.
Final moments of round number one.
Very exciting first round for both guys.
And some good leg kicks just to finish round number one.
Round two, and both these guys look fresh and ready to go, which is awesome. I'm hoping to see more of the same in the first round.
He's very solid in his stance, isn't he, John?
Yeah, definitely. He's put himself in a position where he's felt better, and he can throw hard. So Ken obviously needs to be careful coming in.
Yeah, it sort of has the advantage of being able to throw hard, but also the disadvantage that you're not going to be quite as quick on your feet, maybe. But wow, he comes back again.
And there's that blitz again from John, who's really enjoying himself in there. Nice.
But as you said, Ken's super relaxed, isn't he?
Yeah, and Ken's setting up that left high kick, which is perfect when you come out against an orthodox fighter. It's always there. So he's setting it up. He's showing those low kicks, and he looks like he wants to go high with that high left.
And there's what we were saying, too, just with that flat-footed stance of John's. That front foot isn't sort of as mobile, so it is open to those front leg kicks.
Yeah, definitely. And I think if Ken's corner, I'm pretty sure they would have. That's a low shot there.
It's the old 10 seconds later, it starts to hurt trick.
Oh, yeah, that's the worst.
So you know, usually the referee sends them off to the neutral corners, and John will have up to 5 minutes recovery time should he choose to use it. They tend not to, though. They tend to sort of... Oh, sorry, not John. Ken, 5 minutes rest. They tend not to use the whole 5 minutes. Usually it's 30 seconds to a minute and they're back in it.
Yeah, depending on the severity. It's never usually more than a minute. It's either a minute or the fight's off.
And the ice packs out.
Yeah. Really like what Ken's doing. He's really trying to circle John to his right and set up that left high.
He's just sneaking a little bit of room each time, trying to.
Yeah, it's nice. He's feigning. He's showing the inside. He's feigning. Just seeing what John does. John's obviously the shorter fighter. He really needs to sort of carry on with what he was doing in the first round and really do those blitzes coming in. Yeah, that was a nice right kick to the body. Yes, nice.
They got a bit of power on them, those kicks, they're good.
John really needs to keep that right hand up. Because Ken is sitting there left high up.
Yeah, I think he's thinking twice about doing that blitz again because... Oh, nice kick.
Ah, yeah. And obviously the same goes for John. He has the right high kick just as much as Ken has the left high.
Yeah, when two opposite stancing fighters face off, they leave themselves open to the same attack. So it's quite interesting.
Yeah, exactly. It goes both ways.
Well, end of a second. We'll see a third coming up in just a moment. Third and final for the boys.
There we go. This is when it gets tricky because both fighters now, this is when they get tired, this is when the form starts to fade, the hands start to drop. But Ken is looking pretty disciplined. He's keeping his hands up.
I'd like to see what happens when it goes to the ground.
Yeah.
Don't know too much about these two guys. Don't know how strong their grappling is.
Yeah, these guys are chosen to keep it on the feet for the first two rounds. No arguments from the crowd.
And I think John's about to attack again. You can just see he's getting himself all amped up, ready to go for that blitz that Dylan was talking about in that first round.
Yeah, it's definitely to John's advantage to work that, work his power, work his speed, get inside. But he's not doing anything. The problem is he's not doing anything when he does get inside, so He needs to make the choice whether he's going to chase from that strike in or taking him down. There's nothing there.
So the ref's saying that was a groin kick, is he? Groin kick.
Yeah. Kim's not even responding to it.
He's getting a warning.
Really? There's nothing in it.
Maybe from the height that Thomas Churchill looks at it, it might have looked like it was a bit of what it was.
Showing off. Oh, nice. Nice left round again.
These boys picking up the pace a little bit for the final round, which is great.
John seems to be mean mugging him now. He's hoping that's going to work.
Yeah, he's put the angry face on, hasn't
he? Yeah. Ken staying nice and loose. Very elusive. Picking his shots.
Oh, now he's jumping around a little bit lighter. Beautiful.
Ah, Superman punch there from John.
Come on, loosen up those feet a bit. Let's go. That's it. That's it. I like it.
He really needs to keep those hands up, though. He's coming in with those hands down.
Final moments of this fight, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get this guy's going.
Here we go. I think the aggressor in this round is going to take the fight.
Yes, beautiful combination there. Straight left right hook from Ken.
He's starting to smile a bit too, Ken.
Yeah. He knows that he's feeling his rhythm, he's getting into it.
Oh. He's got to watch out for those ones. He's a strong boy, John.
Yeah, John definitely looks like he has that one punch finish. Oh, he gets the takedown last 10 seconds for John. That could. Well, it's going to help him on the scorecards.
And we go to the judges' scorecards for the first time tonight.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think? Close fight. We're going to the judges' scorecards. Our first judge scores the fight 29-28 to John Borg. Our second judge scores the fight 29-28 to Ken Mcandrew. And our third judge scores the fight 29-28 for a split points decision to our blue corner, John Borg.